Morning, all.
Good morning.
Welcome to computer science class. So now we have only few students, so don't be absent. I can see everyone in a single screen, so I don't have to move to the next screen to view all. Okay, Shivani, Aryan. Okay, so let's revise our database concept, DBMS. Srihari, what is a relation?
Table
is called as a relation. We should not forget that. Okay, then. Ashwin, what is cardinality? Cardinality.
Ma'am, number of rows.
Sure, or number of columns?
No, number of rows, number of columns. Number of rows, ma'am.
once again, just think.
I'm cardinal this number of rows.
Okay, 100% sure. Okay. Mohammad Adim, what is degree? Mohammad Adim is stuck. Shivani, what is degree? Degree. You're absent for the class and you haven't watched the recorded video also, isn't it? Shivani, Aryan, what is degree?
Number of columns in a table.
Very good. Number of columns as called as degree. What is a record? Srihari. Yes, Srihari, what is a record?
Ma'am, collection of data. Collection of data.
Think. Record. What is a tuple, Srihari? What is a tuple?
Other name of row, ma'am.
Huh?
Other name of row.
Once again, I did not hear
row,
you.
Ma'am, row.
Row. Okay. Row is called as a record. That's it. Okay. Now let's continue with our topic. Okay. Just a minute. Gauri. Degree of this table, which is displayed on the screen. Look at the screen. Gauri, we are waiting here.
Four.
Okay, good. Achyut, next question.
Ma'am, four.
1, 2, 3. Very good. Aditya Raj, next question.
Ma'am, four.
What is the question?
Attributes of the table.
Attributes of table.
Columns of the table.
Columns of the table.
Format.
Is the question is count the attributes of table, Adithraj?
No, ma'am.
So what is the answer?
Book code.
Very good. Book name.
PUB.
Price. Okay, that is the question. It's not count the attributes of table. Attributes of table. What are the different attributes of table? That is the question. Diya. Next question. Example of a tuple.
Book code BOO1.
Book code BOO1. Atul, turn on your video.
B1 letter C BPB 400.
Very good. Diya, hope you understood. Tuple means an entire record. That is one row you have to say. Okay, Diya?
Yes, ma'am.
Then who else left? Emmanuel. Fifth question. Shivani, turn on your video. Emmanuel. Next question. Read the question. Fifth question.
Data types of book code and price.
As studied in Python. You haven't studied data types of MySQL. So you tell me what are the data types of book code and price as studied in Python. In Python, you have studied many data types. So from that, what can be B001? What can be 400? Data type. Yes. Data type. Think about Python. Forget about SQL. Which is integer? Is price or book code?
Price.
Price is integer. Very good. Then book code. There is alphabet, then new numbers. So, in which category? Just
data types.
So you need to check the data types. It is an example of a string data type. Okay, string data type. A string data type means it can consist of alphabets or numerals, or we'll call it as alphanumeric values. Since one B is there, you have to enclose it in quotes. So it cannot be considered as numbers. It is called as string. String data type in Python. But here in MySQL, the data type is different. But in Python, if you compare with Python, this is a string data type. And 400 is a integer data type because there are no decimal points in the values. Clear, Aryan? Shivani, what is degree? What is degree?
Ma'am, number of column in a table.
Okay, cardinality?
I forgot.
Number of columns, degree. Then what can be cardinality? Number of rows or number of tuples? Okay? So next heading, you can write down keys, K-E-Y-S, keys. Okay. Each and every attribute in the table is called a key. Roll number is a key. Okay. Mark is a key, a column. And we have to study many different keys. So as I told you in the previous classes, say for example, a student table. So there is one column that is called, one field that is called as roll number. So what is the need of that roll number if you have name to identify the students? What is the need of a roll number idea? You have separate name, Aryan. So why you have a roll number, one extra thing called roll number? Aryan, yes?
To correctly identify.
Correctly. Then if I call you Aryan, it won't be identifying you. That why always be. In your answer sheet we are writing roll number is this, name is this. Why? Huh?
There can be more Aryans.
Ah, very good. There can be duplication of names in a class, isn't it? But roll number is never repeated. It is unique. Roll number is unique. That is why you are using roll number. Okay, clear? The same way we have to uniquely identify each value from the table. For that, we use a separate key. So each and every column, you can consider it as column heading. You can consider it as keys. So just imagine about candidates. What are the different candidates? What is a candidate? Who is a candidate? Gauri? When is the election? Panchayat election? Gauri?
I don't know about election.
When is the election, panchayat election? You don't know that?
10th, ma'am.
Tomorrow, Gauri, tomorrow. Not tomorrow, sorry. Thursday, isn't it? 10th, sorry. Thursday is the dates, panchayat elections. You should know all these things. So today itself, go home and ask the write down the different candidates' name in each parties. Okay, you send to me. You ask your parents. So you should have some. You should have some updates, news updates. Okay. So what is a candidate? Who told Achyut? Or who is a candidate? Not what is a candidate. What is a candidate in DBMS? Now who is a candidate in election?
Any person who is standing for the election. And he has a chance of becoming an elected member.
Okay, and panchayat member, whatever it is, to the panchayat or block. Okay, so that that person is called as a candidate. They are giving nominations, isn't it? And the nominations will be checked by the election commissioners, and they will sometimes they will reject it or sometimes they will accept it. Only then they can start campaigning, isn't it? Isn't it, Achyut? Isn't it?
Yes, ma'am. Oh. Yes, ma'am.
So my question is, there are certain qualifications or rules or regulations are there to become a candidate, isn't it? I am not asking the rules or regulations, but certain merits, sometimes there are certain rules or regulations, so they have to keep the rules or they should be under that certain rules or regulation, otherwise candidate nominees that will be rejected. So that is called a candidate. So who will become the panchayat member after the election? Achyut, question to Achyut itself.
The person who gets most number of votes.
Most number of votes. Okay. The same way here in DBMS, we have candidates. Candidates for whom different, all the key, I told you, different column attributes are called as column heading value, names are called as keys. So roll number is a key, name is a key, then what else, class is a key, mark is a key, address is a key. So just imagine they are candidates for the election. There is this one election is there, that election is for primary key. Election is for primary key. So many candidates are there, and these candidates should have certain qualities. The first quality a candidate should have in our DBM table, that is, the value should be unique. And there should not be any empty values. Okay? The values should not be repeated. So in a table, there can be many candidate keys which are eligible to become a primary key. So here the election is for primary key. So what are the different qualifications for a candidate? Srihari? It should not be repeated. Okay. The values should not be repeated. Then unique values, that is the meaning of repeated. Then that particular column heading, that is that particular column name is an eligible candidate for primary key. So many candidates will be there, and we will select the most appropriate column to become a primary key. Okay. So there are primary keys and candidate keys. A candidate key can be a single column name or a combination of different column names. Okay. So from that, we will select the most appropriate key. So that key is called as primary key. So there are candidate keys and prime. So then what is a primary key? A primary key is a key which uniquely identifies each row from the table. In this example of student table, roll number is the primary key, isn't it? It will not repeat and it is not empty. So roll number is there. When you say your class, there is no one extra Aryan. Aryan is only one, but there is chance. So we can, point of view, we can select the name field as a candidate key, but there can be chances that there are many repeated names. Same names can be repeated in a table. So from the candidate keys, we will select the best one as the primary key. So what is a primary key? Ashwin?
I don't know how to tell. Could you tell that?
Primary key. Primary key is a key or an attribute which uniquely identifies each row from the table. If I say roll number 3, there will be only row, isn't it? Who has roll number 3 in your class? Roll number 3. Emmanuel, what's your roll number? No roll numbers.
No roll numbers.
Could you say that once more?
Primary key. Primary key is a key which uniquely identifies each row from the table. Suppose Aryan's roll number is 1. So if I select the table with who has roll number 1, then you will get only one row of information, isn't it? Srihari, will we get more number of rows with roll number 1? No, only Aryan's. Aryan, 1 roll number 1, Aryan, the details. So primary key is a key which uniquely identifies each row or each tuple or each record from the table. Then whatever other keys, they are called candidate keys. The rest of the keys which are eligible for primary key positions are called as candidate keys. So what is a candidate key? Eligible for positions of primary key. They are called as candidate key. A specialty of candidate key is it can be a single key value or combination of columns, like roll number plus name can be a candidate key. Roll number plus address can be a candidate key. Okay, candidate key can be a single key, single attribute or combination of more than one attribute. Okay. So from that we, so roll number, say for example, from the candidate keys we will select only the most suitable one as primary key. Okay, then the rest keys are called as alternate keys. Alternate keys to primary key. So primary key, candidate key, alternate key. So each and every keys which are eligible to become primary key positions are called as candidate keys. From the candidate keys, we will select the most suitable key as primary key. Then the rest of the other keys are called as? Aryan, called as?
Alternate keys.
Alternate keys. So these are the different keys you have to learn. One more key is the, oh yeah, sorry, not share the screen. What is it? Okay. One more key is the, that I will tell you. Primary key, candidate key, alternate keys, and foreign key. This is a proper definition. The other definition is also correct. The candidates for primary key position. One primary key in a table. So no duplicate values. And mandatory entry, that is not null. We cannot left it blank. Is that clear to everyone? Primary key, candidate key? Hello. Is that clear, Aditya Raj? Primary key and candidate key and alternate key?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So one more alternate key definition I will show you. Alternate key. In case of multiple candidate keys, one of them will be selected as primary key and rest of the column will serve as alternate key. A candidate key which is not a primary key is an alternate key. Next heading you can write as foreign key. Foreign key. Who's a foreigner, Shivani? Who's a foreigner?
Outside from our country.
Have you seen the movie Kilometers and Kilometers?
No.
No? Oh, so sad. How many of you have seen that movie? Ashwin, have you seen?
No, ma'am.
No, nobody has seen. Only me. Adyan, Gauri, Aditya, Diya. No, Achyut. No. So nobody is a Tovino fans. Okay, so nobody has seen Kilometers and Kilometers? No. Very good. Okay, that's a comedy movie. There's a foreigner, one lady. She's from US, I guess. So she comes to Kerala. And so when some foreigner comes to Kerala, then we will call them as foreigner, isn't it? So what about us then? We are? Achyut. We are in India. Then we'll be called as? Citizens. Natives. Natives of India.
Yeah.
So foreigner means somebody is coming. And in that movie, finally, the hero marries that woman. So what happens is one foreigner came to Kerala and became a part of Kerala. So that is, again, called as foreigner itself. In this, exactly in the same way, there are two tables. Okay, listen carefully, there are two tables. One table, just imagine one table is Kerala. Okay, India. One table is India. Another table is US. US. Here, many column names are there. And there, many column names. And here, we Indians, we have, say, our Aadhaar card number. Example. That is our primary key for Indian citizens, native. And for them, there is some green card, some other numbers will be there, isn't it? In US, they have a certain number. They will be having an identity card. Their identity card is the number. When that particular primary key column is coming to some another table, okay? Understood? From that table, from that US table, their primary key column is coming to Indian table and becoming a part of Indian table. Then in Indian table, it is called as foreign key. Understood? Hello? Why no response? Ashwin, someone tell me.
No, ma'am.
No. See, two tables are there, okay? Two tables. Ashwin, question will be asking, I am asking to you because I need response from you. Only then I will understand whether you all understood or not. There are two tables. Each and every table should have a primary key, okay? That's clear. Each table should have a primary key. Is that clear, Ashwin?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, I will leave our India and US. Let's take student table. In student table, student roll number is the primary key. Is that clear?
Yes.
There is a teacher table. In teacher table, teacher ID is the primary key. So two separate tables. But coming under one database that is called school database. So in teacher table, teacher ID is the primary key. In student table, student ID is the primary key. Now, the roll number of student, that is the primary key of student table, and it is appearing as a key in teacher table. Okay? Hello, Ashwin?
Yes, ma'am.
Student roll number field is coming as a field in student table. sorry, teacher table. Then in teacher table, roll number is who? Is it its own key? No, right? It is coming from some other table. Then roll number in teacher table is called as foreign key. In student table, it is primary key, but in teacher table, roll number is foreign key. That's what?
Now yes, ma'am.
Understood. Why we are doing this connection? In order to make relationships. One teacher is teaching this particular students. In order to create relationships, we use foreign key. Okay. That is specialty for foreign key. So there is a complicated definition for foreign key. I'll show you. When the question is, what is a foreign key? You can't write, consider two tables. No, you have to write a definition, right? So this is the first one you need to write. Create relationship between two tables. And it is a non-key attribute. Why it is a non-key attribute? Teacher table, it is ID, teacher ID, teacher name, etc. And one extra. ID, this is teacher table. Name. Roll number. Teacher ID is T01, T02. Yeah. Roll number of student is 1. Are you our biology, right? Aryan? Hello? No. Not biology.
Maths.
Suppose you have taken, math students are here. Suppose you have taken biology. So Divya ma'am is teaching you, I am teaching you. Okay, that is the meaning of this. So this is teacher table. And this is student table. So number, name. 1, 2. Arjun, Ashwin. So in student table, roll number is a primary key. In teacher table, ID is a primary key. And in student tables, primary key is coming as a key. It's not a key of teacher table, but it is coming as a key in teacher table, then it is called as, this is called as foreign key. Okay. That is why it is written, it is a non-key attribute, because it is not an attribute in teacher table. Whose value is derived from the primary key of another table. This is the proper definition you have to write for a foreign key. Understood, Gaudi?
Yes, ma'am.
So what is it? It is a non-key attribute whose value is derived from the primary key of another table. And some more specialities are there for primary foreign key that you will see in the next class. Okay? Take care. Bye-bye.